More than 900 students from Riverside, Inyo, Mono, and San Bernardino counties brought more than 800 projects to the 34th annual RIMS Inland Science and Engineering Fair, held this year for the first time at the engineering giant Bourne's Incorporated headquarters in Riverside. Projects included a wide variety of both science and engineering topics, from ecology and agricultural services to engineering and behavioral sciences. For some, this was the first time they have competed in a science fair on a regional level. For others, the regional competition in past years has been a stepping stone to science competitions far from the Inland Empire.
So my project is about do people make color assumptions? So what I did was I flavored 4 drinks all the same, but I colored them all differently. And so when people tried them, I wanted to see if they thought that it tasted like the color that they assumed it was. So like for my yellow drink, I said that it tasted like lemon. So I wanted them to expect that it tasted like lemon. And according to my results, most of my people were affected by the color of the drinks. I had only 3 people who were not affected by the color of the drink. So I found that people were affected by the color of the drinks. They were also affected by each other. So when people would speak out loud what they thought the drinks were, it also affected how they thought the drinks tasted. Companies can use food coloring to color their toys, drinks, and food to make them more appealing so that people could buy them.
This is my first year at Science Fair. It's absolutely wonderful. The name of the project is The Effects of Mirrors on Dolphin Behavior. The project was focused on whether or not mirrors would be able to affect dolphins' behavior, and if so, does that point to a higher thought process in the dolphins? We've known for a little bit that one species of dolphin called the bottlenose dolphin is self-aware, which means it has an understanding of itself, and one of the biggest factors we can do to test that is to show them their reflection in the mirror and see if they'll use it in a certain way that only animals that understand it's themselves in the mirror can use it, such as using it as a tool to examine body parts.
So for my project, I explained how to keep bananas fresh longer. I put them in different environments, like putting it in a screen bag, which keeps in ethylene, which is the process of ripening fruits. So I researched about it, and it said that the ethylene in the fridge was kind of just disintegrated, so the banana would die. So after the 2-week period, bananas in the fridge were all brown and destroyed, and they were all overripe and gross, and they were brown. And the ones on the counter did the best. My conclusion was that if I were to tell people what to do with their bananas to keep them fresher, would to be put in the screen bag that holds the ethylene and makes them fresher.
I created an assisted robotic arm that allows people with heavy lifting that have muscle disabilities. Well, I found out that there are many people in the world today that have those problems, so I decided to help them out. Well, my final conclusion about it is that it was able to lift up 5 pounds. It was under a budget of $25 and wasted $18. Well, this arm can be used to help the military, firefighters, people in the doctor industry and stuff like that. I actually made it myself. Like, I designed it and did it myself. I want to be a mechanical engineer, possibly like fields of robotics.
My name is Gordon Bourne's. I'm chairman and CEO of Bourne's Incorporated, and we're very pleased to be able to host this year's RIM Science Fair. I did science projects, nothing as sophisticated as I've seen here, and I helped my children do science projects too. Thinking back on one of the science projects that I worked with my dad, it was a Varley electrostatic generator so that I could store static electricity in it. And so I would charge it up, and then I would ask people to touch the top of the jar, and it really had quite a jolt. Well, I've had a chance to walk around and see some of the projects, and I am truly amazed. In fact, there is a 6th grader who has a wind tunnel that will simulate flight on Mars.
It's about designing the correct airplane wing for the drone aircraft for flight on Mars to improve Land Rover capabilities. I want the dowel rod to be attached on the side of the wing so it does not interfere with the flow of the lifting surface. And another thing is I want to write lift to drag ratios. And that's my project. My conclusion? Well, Wing E had the best lift and drag characteristics. And in addition to that, I learned a great deal from all my K-Wings. They taught me a lot about the Kwanda effect and how lift is generated.
Winners were chosen by teams of experts in science and engineering fields, and awards were handed out during a ceremony at the end of the two-day event. Awards were presented with the help of our sponsors and volunteers. The RIMS Inland Science and Engineering Fair is a yearly event and a wonderful opportunity for some of California's brightest new stars to shine. The RIMS Inland Science and Engineering Fair was sponsored by the Riverside County Office of Education, the Inyo County Office of Education, and the Mono County Superintendent of Schools, and the San Bernardino County Superintendent of Schools.